the afternoon. I caught a stray balloon. Sailed away from home to the great unknown. She fell upon the sea. I slipped so easily.
I can't go to Fraser Street now without it being a fairly long and involved process because I meet people I know and I stop to talk. And yet at the same time, it's something I'm really willing to invest in because I see it as something that's very worthwhile. And so public space, the public realm, for me, it's about providing opportunities for building social capital. And so, like, I, you know, I really understand why the city of Vancouver wants to create a town center. And I, you know, I've seen it in many European cities. I've lived in Switzerland for 7 years. And I love the idea of big town squares. And yet even more than one huge area for all of Vancouver, I really see that each neighborhood needs to create a neighborhood center.
With the art plan, as I say, with the neighbors, you know, there was this defining the direction of the art plan was becoming an issue. And we were saying, the BIA was saying, we have our priorities. We want to do this first and this first. We should be able to, or we think we should be able to find a project that we want done and hire an artist to do it. We don't want to tell them what to do. We want to say we want to select the projects. But the neighbors feel the other way. They want to say, here is the art plan, here is our identified, some of our spaces that are identified where pieces, something can go, or you can do something. Tell us what you'll do. You look at the neighborhood and decide what to do. So it's a different philosophy. And this is where the friction comes in. And I don't want to say friction, I just want to say there's a difference of opinion about how we should proceed with the art plan.
I think the BIA really got a lot more than they bargained for. I think they were thinking they would get a plan that would help them get something that looked uniform throughout the street and didn't clash with each other, matched each other. But instead, they began to enter into the world of public art. They realized that they couldn't just do it as a BIA, and so they talked to different people in the neighborhood who were already quite involved in neighborhood things, and so they got a committee together. And they kind of looked at it over a 10-year period, and you know, and now I realize how wise that was, because public art is a very slow thing. Each project takes, you know, a year or 2 years, and so you're not going to rapidly change an area with public art. You're going to only change it very gradually over time. The overall arching theme they came up with was pattern for this art plan. They felt in talking to people in the community that it represented what we value as a community, which is our multiculturalism, which is our diversity, and you can use pattern in a lot of ways to represent that and to celebrate that.
I was the first out of the gate, so I got to do whatever I wanted, basically, within the parameters of that. We ended up working with maybe 12 different cultures in this mural and in the banners that you see around us. They were very excited to talk about these and what it might represent, and it provided me, because I'd already done some research, with people to ask about these things that I had seen, and to say to the Filipino people, tell me, this I've seen this pattern in the research I've done, can you tell me about it? And so this pattern here, for instance, the one in the corner, it comes from a grill work that they use in traditional Filipino houses, originally made out of bamboo. The second aspect of the mural is this frieze that you see up here. I went to meet with another segment of the population, which happened to be a bunch of high school kids at John Oliver High School. I think the students could actually come in here and look at the patterns and say, well, that was mine. They also came down and painted and did a lot of the painting over the course of a very rainy festival that they had here at the end of May. But it was great fun, and they really got into it. And I think there's been huge buy-in by the students from JO and the other schools around here.
Da 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 da
making sure there isn't any loose pieces.
Yeah.
And some of the thin set came up over the tile, so we're just cleaning it up and digging it out a little bit so that there's lots of room for the grout to take. And we're making sure everything is level. And making sure that nothing's loose. We're almost there.
That's good.
Yeah.
Long process, huh?
Yeah.
We've been working on this for
how many years now?
Three years?
Yeah.
4 years? I can't
Almost
remember
three
now.
And half, three and a half years.
Three and a half years.
We used kids in the neighborhood and the community to get themes, and we had kids to do drawings. So some of the, like the sun was done by a child, the dragonfly, some of the salmon. You get your design, you draw it up on a piece of paper, and you get this kind of plastic, I can't remember what it's called, and you put your sheet of paper, cover it with plastic, then you can put the tiles on. That keeps the tiles in place until you're ready to transfer it into the thin set.
Could you push the button for me, please? So, do you like it?
Yeah, it's beautiful. I'm always going to slow down and have a look at it.
One of the owners I'd met when I was working with Renee Van Helm on the mural for the library last year, the year before. In fact, he was very kind and had lent us his ladder. So he was very supportive of the work that we were doing. And when I went in, I wasn't sure what he would think of the instant coffee project. And he came right up to me and said, "Barbara, thank you so much. This project is so fantastic. It's exactly what we need. It will bring people to South Hill." So he understood it implicitly. So why not try to build some kind of a narrative so that as you're moving down the street, there's this kind of cyclical kind of change that's happening. That's also really visually interesting. So Renee designed the banners to be an offset to the imagery that you see on the library. So it's just interpreted in a different way. Art in public space, it also speaks to this idea that one can be attracted to a space and think about a site as kind of a catalyst for an idea to unfold from. And it happens to be in public space. So rather than being in a gallery context, its context is quite different. And that I think that there's a lot of artists who are really interested in kind of a politically charged situation, that art in public space inherently is political.